what the fuck is going on in here on this day?
I promise that you'll never find another like me.
If the title of this song wasn't enough for you, we finally reached that level of self-entitlement that actually extends farther than Ariana Grande's. And I never thought that would actually happen because Ariana is the queen of self-entitlement.
But she's beautiful.
I wouldn't be surprised if this was the case, but in case you are wondering if I actually listened to the entire song instead of going off of other people's reviews and articles of this song, just saying, yes. Yes, I did listen to the whole thing. And...
well, that was a load of shit.
As much as I want to play the entire song to show you every bad thing about it, I think I can easily sum up the badness of it with this one line.
I promise that you'll never find another like me.
What the hell was that?
I didn't think I was going to listen to dolphin impressions in the chorus. But no, that's just the tip of the iceberg. All of the ingredients of this full course meal come from the lame cliche lyrics that Taylor has to squeeze in because this is a pop song after all.
One of these things is not like the others, like a rainbow with all of the colors, and there's a lot of cool chicks out there.
Hey kids,
spelling is fun!
Yeah. I know you never get just what you see, but I will never fall you, babe.
The last time I checked, no one asked for a love song about how perfect oneself is so that the ex could possibly believe in any way, shape, or form that this dried-up TV dinner of a pop song would change his mind about breaking it off with his lover, whether shortcomings come into play or not. In short, Taylor Swift says that this song is supposed to be an empowerment anthem. And supposedly, that makes this all the better. Empowerment anthem? My butt! This is a call for attention! Taylor is that middle child who doesn't get looked at cliche because there are so many other female artists who became more famous after the release of Reputation. Think about it. Look What You Made Me Do came and made an uproar. Ariana's Thank You Next and Sweetener album came after. Halsey's Without Me invaded the radios. Taylor was long forgotten until now. This is not a coincidence.
Sadly, it worked. Taylor Swift is running out of ideas on what to say on her new supposed image, I should say. And this song is basically her way of saying, you untrying fans are not exactly trying enough because so far I'm being beat by a white girl who's pretending to be a Latina hip-hop artist and all the anti-pop princesses that everyone else cares about apparently, yet I have no idea who these people are. It's like I'm listening to that one song from XXXTentacion, XXXX, whoever Tentacion, again.
Look at me, ay, fuck on me, yeah, look at me.
Oh, and by the way, the music video for this song makes Taylor look a million times worse. Really? Snakes again?
Tu en fais vraiment trop.
Comment oses-tu? Et devant nos filles?
Taylor, you're not a French soap opera actress. You're too country-looking to be French.
Je suis calme!
Please stop immediately.
Moreover, the whole thing just looks like a really bad episode of Glee with disgusting CGI added in. I'm just waiting for Darren, Chris, and Leah Michelle to pop up at any second. Now that I think about it, that would make this song a lot better.
I feel that what should make me feel better about this song is that the lead singer from Panic at the Disco features in it. No, it actually makes me more upset.
People were already mad about Panic at the Disco's latest hit, High Hopes, because that song is the least Panic at the Disco that the band has ever reached. And at this point, I can't help but agree despite my love for it. However, I'm going to give High Hopes credit where credit is due because this song is the very least Panic at the Disco that anyone from the band has reached. Panic is an alternative rock band. They always have been, so if anyone is supposed to sound like a jerk in this song, it should be Brenden Urie.
I chime in with a haven't you people ever heard of closing a goddamn door, no.
Since when did Brenden decide that he was going to play the subordinate to Taylor's dictatorship? He sounds like he's singing there against his own will.
Girl, there ain't no INT,
but you know there is a me.
Strike the band of 1, 2, 3.
I think I can say, without any hyperbole whatsoever, that this one performance just destroyed any of Panic at the Disco's chances for further success. I can also clearly and without hyperbole say that this is one of the worst songs of 2019.
You know, whenever anything good happens to this country, how President 45 always takes the credit? Taylor is trying to do the same thing for the concept of pop music. This song is an attempt to remind people that pop music is still a thing because of her. She thinks she's the female Michael Jackson.
Do I even have to say that this song is going to get a 0 out of 10 out of me?
Not today, Satan.
I'm Cait Cher, and I feel terribly, terribly, terribly sorry for anyone who heard this song either yesterday, today, or 2 days ago when it first came out.